Hey fans and subscribers, this is your host Joe on the Gaming for Insight channel, and in this video I am going to be focusing on settings that you can tune to extend battery life in playing the game Lies of P on the Aeneo 2S gaming handheld device. Lies of P takes place in a dystopian world centered around the story of Pinocchio to save Krat from a danger that has taken place in the city. There are two areas that I am going to look at for settings in this video. The first is a profile that I have created through ASpace 2 Beta, and the second is the in-game settings of Lies of P. So let me start with the settings of ASpace 2. I'm in the performance area right now of ASpace 2, and I have a Lies of P profile that I have created, and here are the settings for this profile. So let me start with the FPS limit. As with my videos, I like to target between the 30 and 40 frame rate range, and so I have the frame rate limit at 40. And this can be set also in game, which I will show as set as well. Our TDP limit, I did not expect this, but the limit that is appropriate, that works best, is 16. I see in the game that the baseline range is 14 to 15. I've seen some jumps to 16, but then right back to 15. So expect that range when playing this game and targeting the 30 to 40 frame rate range. Our power policy is going to be set to saving. This is a measure to extend battery life. Our fan configuration, this is by preference. I set mine to hardware control. This reverts to the preset settings in the BIOS for the fan curve. The CPU clock I have as locked at auto. Now we are working with the AMD Ryzen 7 7840U, and its base clock is 3.3 gigahertz, and its maximum boost clock is 5.1 gigahertz. I did not see any consistency playing this game with the base clock. It seemed to jump all the way from the lower 1 gigahertz range to the 3.5 gigahertz range. So I did not feel comfortable locking this at a certain clock speed, and that's why I leave it at auto to give flexibility for that clock speed to move around as needed for areas of the game. And in trying different areas, I still did not see consistency with the clock speed of the CPU component of the APU. But I did see consistency with the GPU component of the APU. I saw a range from 800 megahertz to 1.2 and 1.5 gigahertz, and the 780M has a base clock range of 1.2 to 1.5 gigahertz, and I did see the upper 1.5 gigahertz range, but not quite at 1600 megahertz. So this is why I have the GPU lock at 1600 megahertz, so to provide some flexibility there for the clock speed to move around as needed. Our CPU turbo is going to be disabled. This is a measure to extend battery life. And that is going to be our profile for performance created for Lies of P. Okay, I am in my instance of Lies of P. I am going to navigate to the in-game settings, specifically the graphics settings. Let's start with the screen mode. This was not set at default. I prefer to use the 800p resolution to game on the Aeneo 2S that allows me to use the full screen for playing the game. So to do that, I needed to set this at maximum screen instead of the borderless screen mode, as doing that would have me at the 1920 by 1080p instead of the 800p. Now, it is a measure to extend battery life, arguably so. However, the 800p is going to allow us to more easily target the 30 to 40 frame rate range. And I did some initial testing with the 1920 by 1080p, and the 30 to 40 frame rate range is possible, but what I did see with the 800p resolution is that our frame rate stayed closer to 40 instead of going from the lower 30s to upper 30s. And having that fluctuation there. So using the 800p resolution, it's going to be a smoother gameplay experience. And as I mentioned before earlier in the video, our max frame rate here, we are going to set that to 40. Now we are working with a 60 Hertz display, so I have VSync enabled, and this is going to contribute to a smoother gameplay experience. Our adjust brightness is going to be adjusted based on preference, so use your preference to adjust brightness. The AMD Fidelity FX Super Resolution 2, I actually had this set as off, and it is not needed to target close to the 40 frame rate limit there. So this is based on preference as to whether you would like to enable this and use this. If you are interested in doing that, I recommend using quality, as that is going to allow the frames to be closer to the 800p resolution when scaled up to the 800p resolution, in this case based on the resolution set in game. Though with these settings, it is not needed to have FSR enabled. And the AMD Fidelity FX Super Resolution 2 sharpness, adjust that based on your preference if you have FSR enabled. AMD Fidelity FX CACAO is enabled or on by default, and this is the Fidelity FX Ambient Occlusion, creating a more realistic geometry shading. AMD RDNA architecture is optimized for ambient occlusion, which is CACAO, and this dynamically helps improve the appearance of objects based on ambient light. So I left this on, remaining at the default value. Now the graphics quality preset, I found that this was set as medium by default, and I changed this to low, and I also have these all set at low only by selecting low here. All right, and that is going to be it for the settings for in-game on the ANEO 2S with Lies of P. All right, and that is going to be the conclusion of this video focused on Lies of P and settings you can tune to extend battery life in playing the game on the ANEO 2S. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comments, have you picked up this game? Are you playing it on the ANEO 2S? If so, what settings are you using to play the game? All of this, I am excited to read in the comments, so let me know. And with that, let me leave you now with the words of Commander Shepard from Mass Effect, I should go.